one to say a shout out kind of to all the Lawrence. You know, he's actually not Marlboro anymore, but in my eyes, he's always been Marlboro Lawrence in a way.
Yeah.
But he had a couple, he had three heart attacks in the last 2 days here.
Yeah.
Back to back, yeah. And, it might be his time, you know, it might be his time coming up, but you see what I'm saying, you know. I wish I could kind of talk to him, but I
want to
give him a shout out.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, maybe you should talk to him in person. Like,
yeah.
Also, but then again, you never know. You don't want to say anything to.
I'm not trying to upset him. You know, this is a lot. You know what I mean? Like, I'm just saying, I don't know if this is the time to know or not, man. It's like, I haven't felt anything yet. But I think.
But if it is.
If it is, yeah. I'd like to be there and help. I guess I just
want to
put that on the record, you know.
I guess.
Yeah.
Well, I'm the same way, like, you know, if like, I don't mind sitting, if you know somebody with disease that's dying or cancer that you know that needs someone to talk to them about death,
yeah,
and about what's coming, and if you need, you know, if you yourself need some help or someone to talk to about this, or you know somebody that needs to talk about things like this, we gladly come and do it, you know?
Yeah, I think
we've done this before. Like I said, usually we're dealing with violent death and homicide and murder and murder and stuff like that. But we can deal with other things, and we do, you know?
Yeah.
So if y'all need help, you know, with someone dying of a terminal illness, something like that, they need someone to talk to, let us know on that too. We'll come on out and help. So, but, something I was going to say, I don't know, it's just a lot of stuff to comprehend, and it says, I know, I can imagine the guys out there being like, what the fuck is that Jeremy and Matt going through, you know, that's how I almost feel it, I feel it like that,
yeah.
What the fuck are they talking about, and
yeah,
what are they going through, you know, yeah, it's so hard to explain.
Yeah, I don't know.
I wish I could.
How to tell? You gotta tell you what it is that we, you know, what I feel that we've accomplished here. But, yeah,
our lives are changing.
Yeah, we're talking different people. Like, it's relevant. Believe me, it's evident to people. It's relevant.
And it's coming true. Yeah. You know, the dreams we always had to help others are coming true.
Yeah.
And oh yeah, and our teaching is that you can do this too.
Absolutely, that, you know.
And
there's nothing but what I call, you know, social conditioning or something. You know.
That's all that's holding you back. Like, you've been conditioned by schools and this society and this world and TV even to be a certain way. And it's not like that.
Yeah.
You have to break out of that set of mind. You can break away from that and be something else, then you'll turn into a whole new human being. You'll be completely different.
Yeah.
But you know, that's our goal, is to help people like that.
Yeah, you have to break out of that shell, you know.
Just for time. We're talking about time here, and we're worried about the time on the video camera. I got somebody thinking about time. Decided to program it a certain way, turn off automatically at 59:59, so I'm recording. Yeah, 13 minutes. But I hope this has been a productive session here. I know it's not, every day is different. And Tony Moe's going to be here today, but he's working on fiction scooter. And they were having to Tony to talk about the male and the female Tony. Talking about music enrichment, you know,
yeah,
and maybe demonstrating some of this stuff. You know, the girl Tony writes beats, the other Tony does beats, music, and rhymes. So, you know, yeah, we're having them on soon, and other people, Cecil too. Yeah, I saw them last night. It's funny because last night, like, I got to a friend's house, and his, baby mama's friend was there, and turned out she had questions talking about her dad that died, and that she's talking to him. She talks to him while she's working around the house. And something like that, I could see him, you know? And it turned out it was correct what I was seeing. But, you know, I was telling him, like, look, you know, he's here. You know, this is what he looks like. And and you can talk to him. I said, keep doing what you're doing, you know? You're being heard. I said, you're being heard if he's here listening to you while you talk to him as you do your housework. See, like, it seems like I do work everywhere, and I do. It could be at a gas station in line to buy cigarettes. I've talked to people. I heard someone talking.
I've been going into this very, like, deep meditative state of mind a lot lately, man. I have conversations with people from, you know, the other side and people living there, you know, here. Interesting things, man. Like, you know, like, in between dream state and in between life, you know, somewhere in between there, you know.
I've had that experience, you know. It's like a halfway stop or something.
Yeah.
A midpoint.
And just talking. I wake up like out of it talking to myself. Like talking out loud, not to myself, not out loud. Like I'm gonna have the same conversation. I just let it flow. And it just flows. I can still hear what's going on. You know?
Oh yeah.
It's like I'm wide awake, but it's like, yeah, it's real weird now.
It's happened to me before on several different occasions.
Yeah.
Like, you know, where I'm there, but I'm not there. Like, I'm here, I'm hearing what's going on in this room, but yet I'm in some kind of half dimension, halfway in here.
Yeah,
halfway
in there. You know, I'm talking about that. Yeah.
And it's kind of all black. I was seeing it as like darkness, but yet something was there, like a cavern, a cave that was dark. I could feel myself in a space.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, something was going on with her, you know, like I was in my own little happy spot, you know what I mean? I was in a happy spot, you know, I wasn't feeling anything physically or anything, but I'm walking around, you know, probably taking a more leap, you know, and everything's going on, you know what I mean? Still, and I'm like, just worrying about what happened and how I answered questions, and, you know, it gets crazy, man.
I'm good.
I think about doing the show. I dream about doing the show. You know, it's interesting, man, because it's like I'll have dreams about having conversations like this. You know,
I do too. You know, I had dreams where I was there. It wasn't a dream. It was real as this, probably even realer. Walking around, and a woman was talking to me about she had a little boy missing. The boy was missing. You know, and she's like, oh, police keep looking for him, and he's not around. And then, I see a little boy running around behind her. He's crossed over, but she doesn't know that. That was what that dream was about. Like, you know, in the dream, I don't think I ever got a chance to tell him, you know, at that point. You know, but, like, I didn't know what to do. I was like, well, maybe I should go ahead and tell her because I can see him. But she was walking around with her family, and then there was some stage show where it changed to another person who died. It was a young black dude, maybe a teenager, you know, and the casket was open, and there was a group of his friends, and some kind of T-shirt formation, all the same shirt, and a semicircle singing behind it, and then I was walking out behind them on the stage. Like, I stepped behind them, I was like, they were walking out on the spotlight, and I walked out of there with them, and I was like, oh no, I wasn't supposed to be here. And then, like, I kept walking, I didn't trip, I walked off stage, and then I was on some stairs that rolled around back to the other side to the beginning, and I woke up.
Yeah.
I see the meaning of that. It's like each death, each experienced person that I help, you know, each situation is different. And then I go on that stage, and then when I'm done, I just step off. Make a circle around back and come out and do it again.
Definitely will. It's like a wheel of life. You know?
Wheel of life. That's what I felt it as.
Yeah. Interesting.
You know, that was very realistic.
Yeah, I remember you talking about that dream before. You know? That's interesting. Yeah, I remember that.
And then I had more. That was very realistic. You know, I mean, it wasn't a dream. I know that much. It was far more than a dream.
Yeah, yeah. That's what I'm saying. Now, on the flip side of things, I had a dream. I don't know what the one was. I was Peter Pan the other night. I had a dream.